juicy stories for eager ears, hmm?
Talking some sense into that knucklehead. That she-beast would have been the death of us.
Beast? Just making conversation, mate.
Mate, he says.
One day, Moira. One day you'll show 'em all.
got the foulest of the lot on my racks.
Steady, boys, steady. We'll be leaving as soon as we're packed up.
Nothing to report, sir.
Another perfect heist. You sneak with the subtlety of a tried and true cat burglar.
Steady, boys. Steady. We'll be leaving.
Why, thanks. I rather do, don't I? Ha! A few more heists and I'll be a fat cat in no time.
No doubt about it. Your easygoing sleight of hand impresses me greatly, and will certainly continue to be highly...
Plenty of people here.
Steady, boys, steady. We'll be leaving as soon as we're packed up. Shiver me timbers and slimmer me heels.
I can't even smell the sea air over this pot. Slimy, reeking, rotting sea garbage. Slimy, reeking, rotting sea garbage. Slimy, reeking, rotting sea garbage. Plenty of fish in the sea, but I've got the foulest of the lot on my racks.
How lovely to see you again, haver of the beautifully shaped shoulders.
Can't even smell the sea air over this pot.
Steady, boys, steady. We'll be leaving as soon as we're packed up.
Slimy, reeking, rotting sea garbage.
Watch the undead quiver in their mouthy boots.
Aaron and his main friends is the man.
Taurus snake, wing of worm, Roman spice and star. Worm! Boom. and spice them, stir and churn!
Well, I like it!
I've already read this. My nap is slowly filling up with smarts.
Let's see. Halibut, sheep's cheese, tomatoes. It seems.
Well, hello there.
Of the beautifully shaped shoulders.
Made a big change on your throat for the wheel of the good
stuff. Let's see. Halibut, sheep's cheese, tomatoes.
A good day to you.
Cheese, tomatoes,
lonesome, spirit.
lovely to see you again, haver of the beautifully shaped shoulders.
To the zombie problem and a set of silver arrows.
Feed a big cheese on your book with a wheel of the good stuff.
Well, hello there.
No better solution to the zombie problem than a set of silver arrows.
Let's see. Sheep's cheese, tomatoes.
I'm straight. I'm true. Arrows by the dozens.
My map is slowly filling up.
Halibut, sheep's cheese, tomatoes.
Red and orange, yellow and green, the finest veggies.
How lovely to see you again, haver of the beautifully shaped shoulders.
Let's see. Halibut, sheep's cheese, tomatoes.
Good day to you.
I bet Tim Fred's been strung up by his ears by now, devilish thing.
Nice it is of you, the very picture of youth, to break the monotony of an... Pray, let me be forward with you, O sapling rose, O leaf of spring, for my weary mind is troubled, and would I am but an aged elf that has seen the years parade in long succession. Gladly shall I tell you more. Will I regale thee, O whelp of men, with my tale? But not here.
You would listen to my grievances, guide me towards untroubled realms.
Oh, you are truly a wonder, O budding flower of the morn. Yet,
hot spiced wine and a snug little room awaits us on the King Crab's first floor. Let us go there, so that we can warm our bones, yet make shiver our hearts with a tale of loss and sorrow.
Esmeralda these days.
Ah, hello. I suppose you're here to viciously interrogate.
Oh, now, Alistair. Surely you've met your match once or twice.
Ha! The closest I've got to my match is I'll give you a proper life. How gratifying to see you return. You are quickly becoming my favorite customer.
Ah, you have come. Yes, that is most satisfactory. Be gone, brittle mask of age. Hear me now. Repeat the words of Brittle the Game. Yes! A game of blood and brutality, of death and dexterity. Fun as herring the horror harlequin. The elves of Gandavum, they lived in peace. Oh, yes. But one night, when the moon had hid her face, the orcs of the tribe of Khazad-dûm beset our city. They cooked and ate and bore undone. Every last one of us. Except for me, the midnight rambler, away from the city. I was very old back then already. Though indeed I whisper of many years hence. But death shall not find me. Oh, no, I may be frail, a withered grey, but the wealth of kings is mine. Countless assassins have ministered to the vengeance that is my want, and now is almost over. By Kala, Lady of the Last Gaze, I swear it is almost done. Only the very last one of the Khazad-dûm still alive. I have tracked her down. By the curse of the spine spear I have. She does not know her ill-shapen son is setting fast. Color the dusk red, O sword of youth. Bloody the day with the bramble sap that runs through the veins of Victoria. Bring me the amulet that clings to her flesh, soon to fade. And yours shall be the bounty of vindication. Mine shall be its sanguine satisfaction after long years. Victoria. She is the one whose heart must be held in hand, the heart around which the fingers of that hand must clench and tighten. And the orcs of Khazad-dûm, they knew my name. Oh, yes. By the bite of the roving rattler, they knew my design, and so they sought to save their last. An inf. Her name is that of a woman, her employment that of a civilized being. But by the fork of Barbara Maneater, she is nothing but an orc, a cyst of nature. One of a misbegotten litter dragged into life from the tumored womb of a filthy, coarse-haired beast that was humped like a dog. Victoria, librarian, daughter, adopted. My name is...
That was quite the radical change we witnessed. I never would have thought that the benign old man we met outside would turn out to be a vengeance-driven aficionado of assassins.
Death comes a creeping...
He is as much a savage as those orcs. And how is Victoria guilty of her tribe's crime if she was but a babe at the time?
Indeed. Victoria probably doesn't even know about her...
Here I wait for thee. Yes. 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 Her name is that Victoria. Sword Shredder,
The end is nigh. Death comes a creeping for you, Victoria!
What? Oh, it's you! What news? Someone wants to see Victoria dead? That cherub, hear you me. You must stop that dog by any means necessary. As mayor of Sycile, you have my permission to take drastic measures if need be.
Suluma, soul shredder, the end is nigh.
Bah!
Comes a creeping for you, Victoria!
Place this book here. A volume of poetry of Turjageta, friend. Kiral is sore. Oh, do pardon my language, my friend. But that is quite the startling revelation. So much sadness, so much anguish. Eglandir's tale is heartrending, though it seems that in the pursuit does he not see that I am now the one who is to be wronged? Why, oh why, must he make me, of all gentle-minded and life-loving creatures, why must he make me the target of his imperished soul? Let us approach the situation with reason and ask ourselves, where do we go from here? Though, first let me say this. Rashizam bil kushum zunum. From my heart, I thank you for warning me. I thank you and I trust you. So pray, let me pose the question. What do you advise we should do? My amulet? But it is Haxmaji, a sacred token that houses the presence of my ancestors. No, I cannot part with my talisman, the keepsake of my soul. I guess I cannot say that it is. I do this very reluctantly, but fine. Have my talisman. May it fool the elf that would...
Death comes a-creeping for you, Victoria! Here I wait for thee. Yes. Yes.
Yes. So it is. So it is. By Angus the Impaler's favourite stake, you've done well by me. Oh, ravager of Gazaldagar, the last of them.
Thank you.
hunter. Not exactly the friendliest bloke, the captain, is he? Well, your reward for getting your ear chewed off is a waltz through the town's finest magical...
Looking good.
Another adulterous harpy. No doubt she's guilty as sin.
Another? I don't know which Cycile you've been turned through, buddy, but this one ain't exactly an adulterous harpy nesting ground.
Looking good.
I suppose you're written, Esmeralda, more works of lyrical mastery than I can count. All that letter proves is my devotion to my lady, not any actual intention to do a...
Come now,
Alistair.
Surely you've met your match once or twice.
Peace be with you, traveler. I once lived lonely, never...
She were killed.
May the seven keep you.
Yes? Discovered anything? Well, have you found any incriminating evidence against her? If so... The knife, the book, the letter. They seem harmless enough by themselves, but in conjunction, they do paint a pretty grim picture. Fine, then. If you're certain she... I see. You've come to report a dead sheep. A heap of mutton that sailed into view upon your robbing the grave of a camp. Well, don't just stand there gawking like guppies. Hie yourself to Robert the Mortician. If anyone buried a sheep, obviously it was him.
Get the same recruit.
Sorry, sir.
Feeling hot under the collar.
What on earth would an undertaker want with...
Now, there's my papa. Did it move out legs and run away?
So, what's the bad news? More orcs rampaging through the docks? Or have those infernal statues sent another... This here is my family business. Yes, there's been a Roberts escorting stiffs into the next life since the foundation of Sycyle itself. They don't write epics about morticians, but I'm proud of my work. Sad story, that. Though if I'm speaking plainly, the sentimental aspect of it all doesn't make much of an impression on an undertaker. Especially not these days, with so many laid low by the orc. I just concern myself with giving the remains a respectable exit from life. We set him to rest in the northern graveyard. Perhaps he can...
A sheep? That's a whole heap of nonsense. Don't bother me with such...
Go ahead and try it then. I haven't got anything to tell you one way or the other. Enough of that bloody business.
If you're just going to bother me about finished matters, I...
has reason to suspect Mayor Cecil, Captain Aureus, Evelyn, and Esmeralda of something.
So, what's the bad news? More orcs rampage? How do you... Ah, the ledger, is it? Fool was I to leave it in the open. Or perhaps I even looked forward to being found out. Well, as you know, I have plenty of us shopkeepers entrust the mayor with the spare keys to our businesses, you know? And he's the only person in town with a second copy of the key to the mortuary. He could have used it to sidle in without a peep, if he were so inclined. Aureus himself paid me a visit the night the body was delivered. Came rapping at my door in the frosty morning, before the sun had even started peeping, and told me to tell him, and only him, if I noticed anything strange or suspicious about the remains. Can't see why he'd bothered to go through all that trouble. Unless he knew something the rest... I know it sounds strange suspecting the doctor's apprentice of something so ghoulish as this, but there's few in this city could manage to transport a corpse without raising eyebrows. It was she who delivered Jake's body from the inn to the mortuary. And there was something about her that night. Some kind of excitement. Seemed she could barely contain her thoughts. That there was something thrilling about to happen. I can't quite settle it in my mind how a young medical professional would have such a strange reaction to an occasion such as that. And this may or may not have anything to do with the whole rigmarole, but her master, Dr. Theleron, bought an old shack of mine, one overtaken by undead, for an exorbitant price considering what he was getting. I never did figure what he wanted it for, but he sure seemed eager. I never saw a widow less distraught at the death of her husband, and I've seen hundreds pass through my parlour. It was she who rang my bell just before the body was snatched, lured me outside claiming she needed air, before discussing the funeral arrangements. Some accomplice could have sneaked in and grabbed the remains while I was comforting the oh-so-overcome Esmeralda. That gold's the only good thing to come out of this blasted affair, and I certainly plan on making some use of it.
Thank you.
no need for all that. Take the gold then, and we'll call the rest even, okay? So, what's the bad news? More orcs rampaging through the docks? Or have those infernal statues sent another soul flying to his death?
Freezing? Silver? Poison? Get to the point.
Quiet day on the market, it seems.
Yours for a scrap of gold leech.
quiet day on the market, it seems.
To what do I owe the repeated pleasure, Source Hunter? The world belongs to the young, they say, and Boris will live to take his piece. Well, she certainly possesses a critical eye, and I expect she'll be a very successful healer in her own right.
Hello again. Terribly sorry, Source Hunter, but is that so? Well, I handled the corpse myself, indeed, but I hardly knew the man in life. I was shocked when Ahu asked me to come. I arrived at the inn, where the body lay just where it had fallen. The injuries were like nothing I'd ever seen. A single intricate laceration wove like lace around every inch of his... I personally delivered the corpse the short distance to the mortician's house. As far as I know, everything was as far as a magical murder is concerned. That strange reaction you caused...
Again, haver of the beautifully shaped shoulders.
Any takers? Come on, you chickens!
Watch the ant-bears quiver in their mouthy boots.
My nap is slowly filling up with secrets.
How lovely to see you again, haver of the beautifully shaped shoulders.
I hope you are here to shop rather than sleuth. So, what piece of irrefutable evidence? Oh, don't put stock in the hastily scribbled words of a lovelorn fool! This letter, it was a show of passion! A poorly worded passion I did not echo in the least. The Duke, he's like a spoiled child. He's not a man. But all of it is circumstantial. I've a perfectly logical explanation for every piece of so-called evidence against me, and yet you've been trailing me like a bloodhound. People seem to want to believe I am guilty, so let me tell you something I've been keeping to myself. Perhaps it may yet lead to... Over the last few months, Jake grew distant. Distant and dark, somehow. Something in him changed. I can't quite put my finger on it, but he was no longer the... It all began the day he met Evelyn, Master Theliron's apprentice. She healed him of what we all believe to be a fatal wound he suffered hunting boars. I think he became obsessed by her, or obsessed by the secrets I just know she holds. Talk to this woman. In fact, I wouldn't be surprised if she belongs to that sect. You know, to those who worship a goddess without name and practice rituals of blood. I never liked her from the moment I met her. Men cannot see past her beauty, but I have gazed her in the eye, and it was death that leered back.
She hails from Silverglen, a village in the forest north of Sicily. How she made it past the undead without a legion escort, I'll never know. Though I can hazard an eerie guess.
If anyone killed my Jake, it must be her. She had her claws in him for many long months, and finally she must have cut too deeply.
What do I owe the repeated pleasure, Source Hunter? Far be it from her to tell her master what in the seventh name she's up to. The girl flew from here like she just heard the location of the Philosopher's Stone. She even left her pouch unattended in the next room. Most unlike her, to be sure. She usually keeps it within sight at all times. Very strange she'd leave it behind. It's in the next room if you'd like to take a look. I'd try her house, for starters. It's not far from here. I'll mark the location on your map.
Thank you.
got a lair on the beach, does she?
Perhaps that's where she stashed Jake's body.
Sorry, sir. Sorry, sir.
Oh, what now?
Yes, discovered.
It was stolen? Gods, what a fool that Roberts is. Taking a bribe in beleaguered old Sicy.
He has a lot to answer for, but not as much as the one that did the bribing in the first place. Guess your what is in her diary certainly seems to implicate she dabbles in sorcery. Well, you're supposed to be the source hunter, aren't you? Surely you have exhausted all the evidence that was to... Whom would you have the Legion arrest?
It seems.
Thinking about exploring the beach. You're free to go, though we Legion... You don't look like you're quite ready to head out into the wilds to me. You may have the right number of champions in your party, yet in experience, I think you're lacking. Of course, the choice is yours, but are you sure you want to venture? I certainly hope you know what you're...
Look alive, my good man. This gate will be short work for a well-equipped contingent of orcs.
The Sicilians retreated from this battle, But what about the orcs?
Either they've taken to the sea or set up an encampment in yonder caves. Keep your weapon at the ready.
Off my nose, Chasm, in any case. Have a look through my wares if you'd like to find something already wiped clean of orc ooze. My prices won't disappoint.
Away with your weapons! A wife! I don't want to fight. I ain't after no fancy stone. I just want to bury these bodies to... Oh, it was such a dear lad he was. We wanted to see the world, for we saw next to nothing before in our village. Oh, poor Oggy will never see her again. But tradition goes that a warrior should... There weren't so many spoiled after the battle, but I managed to give old Oggy the...
A grave with a full set of hand-picked armor, eh? You've got to know its location.
I second that. His brother was...
You want the location of Oggy's grave? Now, what use could you have for that, small bones? Away with your... Don't play dumb with me, small bones. You know as well as I that your little city here won't be rid of us orcs till my kind gets that fancy-schmancy bloodstone you got in our own town. We honour the dead by decorating their graves with whatever materials we have. In this case, it's wood. And why'd you be needing that information, small bones?
Pathetic heap of source added frogskin thought it could fool us, did it? Old Medora knows for certain that orc would have loved nothing better than to axe you in the back while it cried on your shoulder. You rookies are learning fast. They say every time an orc bleeds, the havoc demon who crafted it loses one of his many.
Well, what's this I spotted? That shovel has proven worth its weight, it seems.
Indeed. And who knows what manner of riches we'll unearth together with this tried and true treasure digger.
Enough to finish this mission with a long vacation in the tropics, gazing side by side at a burgundy horizon.
It's here, just in front of our noses. Oh, dear old Oggy Woggy, big brother will warn you forever. Thank you.
I can't feel my legs.
It's here, just in front of our noses. Oh.
Adventurer, I just my then good friend.
Careful. I spotted a trap.
Is here, just in front of our nose.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. I sing the body electric.
Amber spy scandal.
Thank you.
beats too slowly to sustain me.
You were right there. Deeper. Abundance! See how fast she scuttles? Grips my hands today.
to this queen.
Thank you.
Thank you.
prepared for me.
Stand strong, strike harder.
with your weapons. He's here. Just in our own town, we honored the dead by decorating their graves. Decorating their graves here, just in front of our noses. Oh, dear old orc, I don't want to fight. I ain't after no fancy stone. I just want to bury his body. Oh, he was such a dear lad, he was. We wanted to see the world. Don't play down with me, small, in our village.
I'm quite busy finding for the moment, but Charla is my name, good friend. I came to this second life some time ago, some years. In any case, it has been time well spent hunting out magnificent goods and selling them to in so many wonderful artifacts I've found. So have a look by all means. You'll find you look like just the sort of self-starter to appreciate what I mean. Weapons. 4 of them, that the intrepid adventurer can improve and upgrade as he travels if he finds the right pieces. See them? See them? Judge for yourself.
Thank you.
Goodbye then, good friend. Goodbye.
Oh, poor Albatross.